Good morning, everyone. So let us start today's class with question number 12. I'm just waiting for one more minute for the students to join. They are still in a queue. Okay, so question number 12, prove that a cyclic parallelogram is a rectangle. So I'm making a kind of parallelogram. Make the figure. So make a figure like this, where it is a cyclic parallelogram. Let A, B, C, D be a cyclic parallelogram. You have to prove that it is a rectangle. Given A, B, C, D is a cyclic parallelogram. To prove ABCD is rectangle, today this chapter will get over, including examples. Examples also we'll be able to do today. To prove ABCD is rectangle, starting with the proving part. See this now. As it is a parallelogram, so opposite sides will be parallel. Okay. Right. angle sense ABCD is cyclic. Therefore, angle A plus angle C means opposite angle sum should be equal to 180 degree. Sum of opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. Just write it down. Sum of opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. Also, angle A is equal to angle C, opposite angles of parallelogram. ABCD is also parallelogram, so parallelogram property we are also going to use, and cyclic quadrilateral property also we are using side by side. Now, if A and C are equal, then we can write in this equation, angle A plus angle A means in place of C, we can write A is equal to 180 degree. Now it will be twice of angle A is equal to 180 degree. So angle A is equal to 180 divided by 2. That is 90 degree. Now we can say that ABCD is a parallelogram whose one angle is 90 degree. Therefore, ABCD is rectangle. Note it down. So exercise is over. All the questions from the exercises are over. Now let us move on to some of the important examples from the chapter, which can be asked in tests also. Note it down, we'll move to the next now. Yes, whatever example I am solving here, you have to write in your notebook. Okay, consider this as a part of your exercise. Clear? Consider the examples which we are doing as a part of your exercise. These are equally important as your exercises are. So I am solving here. Rest of the examples you will be able to do. I am solving here two examples. Example number 3 and 6. Okay. Starting with example number 3. Just wait. Next. Example 3. Just wait. those who have not written question number 12, this 12 till now, the C ones, I'm starting with examples. Okay, down. Okay, you need to look at the figure carefully. The figure given in the example, in your book, page number, you can say 183. On page number 183, this question is given. And in that figure, some construction has been done already that I have removed from the figure. Okay, because figure, if a figure will come, it will come in this way. Clear? It will come in this way. Let's start. In this given figure, AB is the diameter. See this, AB is the diameter. And CD is a chord equal to the, just underline, CD is the chord equal to the radius of the circle. So CD chord is equal to the radius. Means this OA, OB, OA is the radius, OB is the radius, and CD is the chord, all are equal. Okay. So as per this, just write given that chord is equal to radius. To prove angle AEB angle AEB 60 degree. And before starting the proving part, we have to just go for the construction. In construction, just join CO, DO, and BC. So I'm making these lines CO, DO. CB. So after joining these, now you need to look at the figure carefully. Proving starts now. See this, we have to prove that AEB means this angle is 60 degree. How we can reach to 60 degree? Before that, just see what is given in the question. Chord is equal to the radius. Since chord is equal to radius, in place of radius, we can write radii, or you can write even radius, no matter. Chord is equal to radius. So this is chord, CD. And this is radius, CO. And also this is also radius, DO. Right? So chord is equal to the radii of the circles. CO, DO are the radii. Therefore, triangle COD is equilateral. I hope till here, is it clear? Is it clear? Till here, we have just joined these three lines. After that, I have written that radius is equal to the chord. So CD, CO, and OD are equal. Therefore, it is equilateral. If it is equilateral, I can say that this is 60 degree. Therefore, angle COD is 60 degree because in equilateral triangle, all angles makes 60 degree angle that we know already. Now you need to look at one of the arc I'm highlighting here. Now this arc, see, I have made this arc CD. This CD arc is making angle at the center. Yes. And this CD arc only is making angle on the circle. Yes or no? There are straight lines present here. Look by your own. This CD arc is making angle here. See this, from D, this line is coming, and from C, this line is coming. Let me draw here a straight line to show you. It is already drawn. I am just making on that line so that you can see this. So all red lines now. See the red lines. This CD arc is making with the help of this red line, the angle at the center, that is 60. And this CD arc only is making this and this angle. Is it clear? Are you able to see this? Yes. So center angle is always double of the angle on the circle. So angle subtended by the arc at the center is double the angle subtended by the same arc on the circle. So by a degree measure theorem, we can say that you can write angle subtended by arc CD. We can write like this, by CD, and let us make an arc here. Means we are talking about arc with the CD. So angle subtended by CD are COD and CBD. So angle COD will be double of angle CBD. Now COD is 60. So this and this cancels out. So angle CBD is 30 degree. Done. If it is clear till here, then rest of the question is very easy. After this is right, angle ACB is 90 degree. Why? Angle in semicircle. Angle in semicircle makes 90 degree. Yes. If angle in semicircle makes 90 degree, therefore ACB is angle in semicircle. So this is 90. Now by exterior angle property, ACB, angle ACB is equal to this plus this. See this triangle now. Now you need to look here in this triangle. Just see this triangle. In this triangle, we have this exterior angle, that is ACB. And this exterior angle will be equal to sum of two interior opposite angles. And the two interior opposite angles are this CEB and CBE. Yes, let this angle be angle 1 and angle 2. So ACB, this exterior angle, is equal to angle 1 plus angle 2, where ACB is 90 degree. And angle 1 we don't know, but angle 2 we know that we have already calculated, that is 30 degree. Let's see here, CBD. Okay, means angle 2 I have written here, but angle 2 is this, that is 30 degree. So 30. So angle 1 will be equal to 90 minus 30. That is 60 degree. Now angle 1 is this only, AEB. Angle 1 is AEB. So in place of angle 1, we can write angle AEB. 60 degree, hence proved. Note it down. Don't write the solution from NCERT example. Okay, write the solution from here. There it is not explained well. They have written this why, and why. Means you need to explain that. So this way you have to do this question. Koshima, till where it is clear? You are saying to repeat again. Till where it is all clear? Is it clear to you? CVD is okay. So CVD is 30 degree. Now let me explain the full question again. Here we have done construction where we have joined CO, OD and CB. After that, just see that radius and chord are equal. Means this chord CD is equal to the radius of the circle. So CD, CO and OD will be equal to each other. So this makes equilateral triangle. So therefore this angle is 60 degree. COD is 60. See this? COD is 60. Now COD will be double of CBD. COD will be double of CBD because both the angles are subtended by CD, and CD is making one angle at center and CD is making one angle on the circle. So this center angle will be double of this. So we have written here that center angle COD is double of CBD. Fine. And in this way, we have calculated CBD as 30 degree. After calculating CBD 30 degree, you can say that by angles in same segment property, sorry, angles in semicircle property. See this, ACB is an angle in semicircle. AB is the diameter of the circle. So above this diameter, we have this semicircle made. And angle in a semicircle makes 90 degree. So ACB is 90. Okay. If ACB is 90, Dhruv and Lakshay, where are you busy? Dhruv and Lakshay, where are you busy? They are not even... Okay. No, they have mind. Okay, Harinder sir. Yeah, talk to them later on. Okay. So here I was just talking about angle in semicircle. See this ACB is 90. Now if this is 90, then this is exterior to this yellow triangle. So 90 is exterior to this triangle. That's why 90 will be equal to 1 plus 2. Exterior angle property. Where 1 we don't know. We have to calculate that. And angle 2 we know that is 30. We have calculated here CBD. CBD is 30. So put the values and take out the value of angle 1, that is 60 degree. So AEB is 60. How angle ACB is 90? Koshima is asking how angle ACB is 90. Okay, then see this. Is See this. This arc, is it a semicircle, Koshima? This? Yes or no? Yes. Okay. Then this is angle in this semicircle. And we have a property, angle in semicircle is 90 degree. An angle in semicircle, no, should start from the ends of the diameter and it should reach the circumference of the circle, boundary of the circle. This is 90, that's why. Okay. Any other problem in this question you can ask? Anyone? Otherwise, I'm moving to example number 6 now. We have to end this chapter today. Count example number 6. Okay, good. Let's start. Prove that quadrilateral formed by internal angles bisectors of any quadrilateral is cyclic. So here, let us draw a quadrilateral once. Draw a quadrilateral, naming it ABCD. Now it is written one thing, angle, internal angle bisectors. So we have to draw internal angle bisectors, making bisector of A, B, C, and D. So bisector of A, bisector of B, bisector of D, bisector of C. So here we have four vertices inside also. A, B, C, D, the bisector of angle A, B, C, C and D makes one more quadrilateral inside. And we have to prove that this internal quadrilateral, let it be P, Q, R and this S. So P, Q, R, S is a cyclic quadrilateral we have to prove. Given A, R, see this, AR, BR are bisector of angle A and angle B. So AR, BR, in the same way, CP and DP are bisectors of angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. To prove PQRS is cyclic. To prove PQRS is cyclic. So let us start with the proving part. No construction required further. Let this be angle 1. This has 2. This has 3. Just note it down. I am just zooming it. Note down these things. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Note it down, be quick. Okay. Or you can zoom and see otherwise. Okay, so PQRS is cyclic. How we can prove this? starting with in triangle ASD. In triangle ASD, we have three angles, angle 1, angle 2, angle 3. So sum of all the angles will be equal to 180 degree by angle sum property. Angle sum property of a triangle. Now, angle 1 and angle 2 are half of angle A and angle D. Angle 1 is half of angle A. Or just wait. Before this, write one thing. Half of angle A plus half of angle D plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree, and give here a reason that AR and DB bisects angle A and angle D. So AR bisects angle A and DP bisects angle D. So that's why 1 is half of A and 2 is half of D. Now take out the value of angle 3. Why we are taking out the value of angle 3? That should be the question in your mind, because look here, we have to prove PQRS cyclic. Okay, so 3 will be equal to 4 vertical opposite angle. So that's why we'll be able to reach to the angle of this quadrilateral. Fine, that's why we are taking out the value of 3, because it is related to the internal angle of the quadrilateral. So take out the value of 3 from here by shifting this to the right side. Minus half angle A minus half angle D. Equation 1. Okay, similarly, in triangle BQC, angle 6 plus angle 7 plus angle 8 is equal to 180 degree. Or no, you can do one thing. You can directly even write. Okay, right like this. So 6 plus 7 plus 8 equals to 180 degree. Better than this, no, just write directly, because you have written similarly using. If you'll be able to understand, you can write directly this way. The way angle 3 here is equal to half of 180 minus half angle A, half angle D. In the same way, angle 6 here will be equal to 180 minus half angle B, half angle C. So there will be same steps. That's why I'm not done. You also can skip an exam even. Half angle B, half angle C. Second, join three and sorry, add equation 1 and 2. Now, angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 plus 180, 360, then half angle A, half angle B, half angle C. So I am writing all minus half angle A, minus half angle B, minus half angle C, minus half angle D. After this, angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 360, taking half common. Then half and minus also have to common, so inside sign will get changed. It will become positive. A plus B plus C plus D. Now sum of all angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree. Yes, no? See this? Angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, all will make equal to 360 degree together. So that's why in place of this, we can write writing angle sum property of quadrilateral. And this cancels out 180. So it is angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 360. Minus 180. Now in place of 3 and 6, no, I am writing angle 4 plus angle 5. Can we write? In place of 3, can we write angle 4? In place of 6, can we write angle 5? Because these are vertical opposite angles. 3 is equal to 4, vertical opposite angles. 5 is equal to 6, vertical opposite angles. Right here, reason why we are able to write this. Angle 3 is equal to angle 4 and angle 5 is equal to angle 6, vertically opposite angles. So angle 4 plus angle 5 makes 180 degree, 360 minus 180. Now opposite angles in quadrilateral makes 180 degree. Therefore, PQRS is cyclic. If opposite angles makes 180 degree, then it is cyclic. This is done. This is the full solution. Wait a second. Note it down. You have 2 minutes to write. Chapter is finished now. Complete this in your notebook. I'll ask for the PDFs of your notebooks also this week. And when I'll ask, then start sending me and keep it ready. Make PDFs and keep it ready. I'll ask you one day this week. The next chapter that we have to start is construction. We have already done now 12th chapter, Heron's formula. From tomorrow, we'll begin that chapter, chapter number 12. Till then, complete this. Okay. Bye. Take care.